Hey, we're getting in the car, Brian.
Now, whoa, we set on something and went to the car.
Okay, well, we're here and we make sure that our gauges are all running properly. And to do that, we first tap them like this and make sure that the needles are moving somewhere. And of course, what we do then is we stick the key in the ignition.
Ah, yes.
We stick the key in ignition and we start our motor. And once the motor started, then we make sure that these gauges are doing their thing again. See? You know, the first time, they do it on their own. You see like that? they're kind of moving just a little bit, so, you know, you can expect them to be going on anytime now. Then we actually take this little nookie here and we stick it in one of these things, and I think probably the best thing to do is to find out how to buckle the seatbelt. But we could probably set it up our own way where, oh, there the thing goes. So after we get our motor started, we then push in the clutch, and somewhere in here is first gear. That's first gear. First gear's one of those things where start out slow, take it easy, and then we shift into second, Brian. Second gear is one of those things where you start out slow and take it again, and then you go into third gear. And then you start out slow and you take it again and you go into fourth gear. And pretty soon, this little needle back up here starts to rev real hot.
Well, I see here there's a little latch bolt.
Damn.
Ah, that's it.
Well, we have a real hot engine underneath this thing here. And I see, we got the regular motor in here. That's a regular motor, and that's a regular air cleaner. God damn, it's transparent. This here, and come on in closer if you want to see what the engine is really like. The engine in one of these mass performance cars is a regular four-cylinder engine, and but it's got a little air compressor on here. This air compressor is gives this baby a rated horsepower of about 400 horsepower from this thing, and that would almost squeal all four wheels. But really, the main thrust of the engine comes from this this pulley right down in here. This pulley must put another 400 pounds of torque in there, and this fan is actually a racing fan. And the reason why there's so much blue in here is that the blue helps the car run faster. Not many people knew that a long time ago, and now since the age of electronics and all those other fancy things, we've now found out that the color of the engine actually has something to do with the top speed. Well, we really don't know what a lot of this other stuff does, but you know, it's over the years, things have become part of racing. A legacy behind it, but not everybody knows the true stories. So, I'm kind of losing my accent here, Brian, because got a cold. Well, that settles that.